оказывается. На странице 2.9, вот тут фотографии.
Take a look at page 2.9, there is a picture.
Да, ну. Так, все, там ВМФ подвел.
ВВ из
Александра.
The rest is there. Do I push the start button now?
Так, что у нас еще? Чего у нас еще нет?
Павел Владимирович, пьеса сейчас какое состояние? Что сейчас происходит? Что-то с пьесой, с датчиком пьесы?
Павел Владимирович, what is the condition of...
15.3. That again was a good look inside the International Space Station, specifically in the Kibo, Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency's laboratory module on the International Space Station. Within that module, there's a number of different research facilities. You can find out more information about all of those on our website at www.nasa.gov/station, where you can not only access a complete listing of experiments that have been conducted on the International Space Station, broken down by the increment or those being actively participated in, but you can also access a complete listing of all of the different facilities and specific research platforms that are available on the International Space Station. Again, that website, www.nasa.gov/station, and the link will be on the left for research and technology, and that's where you can find the breakdown of the experiment listing or facilities listing.
0, 4, 0.
Стартуем?
Да.
Yes, go ahead.
Так, старт единичка, так, пошли шаги, номер шага 4.
As we mentioned, that work that Cassidy was conducting was on the MSPR, the multi-purpose small payload rack, just one of many inside the Japanese laboratory. But science is being conducted by a number of the crew members today. The Russian colleagues are working on the Kristall experiment, which studies crystal growth in the microgravity environment. Luca Pomotano and Karen Nyberg have been continuing with ultrasound scans as part of a intensive ocular health study, which has a number of different components and elements to it. That's something they've been working on throughout the week, using that same ultrasound for eye scans, and at this point gathering data on the cardiac elements of that as researchers try to determine some of the causes and possible countermeasures for vision loss that's being observed in some of the returning crew members. You can find more information about that study on our website as well. As we mentioned, Luca Pomotano is also participating in an experiment called the Skin B experiment, which will contribute to a better understanding of skin aging mechanisms, which are slow on Earth, therefore nearly impossible to study efficiently, but they're very accelerated in the weightless environment. So that makes a great platform for researchers to be able to understand those aging mechanisms better. Not only will this study provide information on the mechanisms behind how skin adapts and regenerates under the influence of weightlessness, but also the environmental conditions in a spacecraft on long-duration missions. It will provide a model for the adaptive processes for other organs in the body as well. Additionally, the data gathered from this will act as a research footprint for comparative purposes with astronauts on future human exploration missions outside of the low Earth orbit. That Skin B project aims to clarify how the skin, as a model for other organs, alters, and if or how quickly a regenerative skin takes place. The experimental data gathered on this space station experiment can be translated in order to provide insight into the mechanisms by which all organs covered with epithelial and connective tissue adapt and age over time, and under the physical stress imposed by the environment. Likewise, gaining an understanding of those tissues and their changing processes should allow for better diagnostic and treatment on the ground. That again, just one of the science and research activities being done by the crew today, a week that's been heavily focused on science as well as some maintenance activities.
Давайте.
Once it reaches 1 by 10 and